traffic congestion in Mumbai leads to commuters spending 135% more time in road travel than any other Asian city. This is a study done by Boston Consulting Group. Now, the study also mentions the city commuters would take 78% more time to travel from point A to point B compared to the time taken in Singapore. So let's leave Singapore. Let's even compare a Delhi and a Mumbai. And I'm going to come to you, Mr. Mishra. The reason why people have to travel so much is just one. They don't have housing in the island city. They have to go to the suburbs. Right. They have to travel so much. Why can't the government, I mean, whether it is slums or redevelopment or salt pans, we'll come to whether salt pans have been cleared or not, but why can't Mumbai get affordable housing stock?
You, madam, I think the journey to work has been always a problem in Bombay city because housing land zoning has been separate from the work zoning land. Hmm. The improvement of the transportation system was in place when local trains were working very efficiently, but it has rightly not been upgraded over the growing population. But here I want to tell you that there are also certain positive aspects with the development plan envisages.
Okay.
In order to improve quality of urban life, which we call urbanism, mm-hmm. the municipal commissioner has actually given directions to every ward officer that they should identify open spaces
okay.
in their zones mm-hmm. and provide these spaces for the development of the community in terms of art. There is a Mumbai Art Commission in place. Mm. Now, UN has declared some of its property as a World Heritage Site. So, there are certain positives of Bombay which we should also celebrate. Now, when it comes to affordable housing, it has been always gone through the process of SRA, where they are trying to provide affordable housing, trying to improve the environment, clean up the whole place. But it has its own problems.
And so, Vilas Nagalkar, should we give up hope on affordable housing in this city?
There are private
completely? Okay. Should we still clamor for it, make it a big issue, talk about it so that there's pressure on the government?
No, there is a positive side to the development plan and the private players will be coming in the affordable housing segment with this NDZ earlier called NDZ because in 1991 DP.
These are the no development zone. Okay.
Because at that time the infrastructure was not available in areas like Malauni where the roads or electricity or the sewer lines were not laid that time. That is why it was no development zone, but it was not a never development zone. So that area is now open for development and the private players who are owning more than 2 hectares of land. So they can contribute say 30% land for the affordable housing. That much share they will transfer to the MCGM or the planning authority. 15% they will keep as a open spaces and 14% they will keep as a amenity, a social amenity like retail market or post office or whatever.
Okay.
And 41%,
so that's there in the plan.
Yeah, and okay. that will be 41% they will use for the self. So all this thing is going to add to your affordable housing stock.
How far is it? I mean, I don't know Mumbai so well. So the NDZs which have been opened up, where are they and how far are they from the business district is my question.
Yeah, these areas are normally located about 4 kilometer range from the railway stations of the suburban railway station. Mm-hmm. And the areas like Malauni, areas like far off Charkop and Gorai, some area. And some of the areas of near Shivara.
These so you're saying at least they're 4 to 5 kilometers from a suburban line.
Network.
A suburban network. Mr. Goenka, coming back to you, are you happy with the open spaces? I mean, it's good to have public open spaces, inclusive spaces. That's a big thing about a city as well. And let's also celebrate something which is positive.
Well, let's go back to basics. Everywhere in the world, you first develop the infrastructure, then you allow the buildings and the builders to do what they want to do. In India and Mumbai particularly, it's the other way around.
It's there all over India, just Mumbai.
Okay, so we
believe the developers build first and they sometimes build the roads also, whether we like it or not, but the government sometimes comes in, sometimes doesn't.
Yeah. So here in Mumbai, typically the buildings come up first, they get occupied and then we start asking where's the water, where's the road, where's the solid waste system. That's the way it works here. And given the fact that Mumbai is a cash-rich corporation, one of the richest in the world, with something like 65,000, 70,000 crore rupees sitting in fixed deposit, we are not short of money. We don't seem to be able to use that money to develop the infrastructure that the city needs. And 18% implementation of the development plan, I mean, that just shows you there is no intention to actually make things happen. Thousands of crores of rupees have been spent supposedly on road construction, road improvement, and yet the number of potholes, the same old problems keep on recurring year after year after year.
Point heard. And you know, this part does come back and really hits everybody, Mr. Hiranandani. Look at the money that BMC has. Despite that, there's so much gap between what is promised and what actually happens, let's say every monsoon or the kind of condition of the current infrastructure. But just also coming back to the affordable housing question, I believe the 330 hectares of salt pan land, right now there's no clarity on it. Am I correct? It's not been released with the...
Yeah, you're absolutely correct. You're absolutely right. Up till now, the clarity has still not come whether the central government is okay to consider these lands. Also, in the development plan, they have not cleared all the issues as far as the affordable housing into the salt pan lands are concerned. And there's a third issue, because there's going to be a CRZ which has been done under the CZ MPA plan. So I think all these three factors will be have to be taken into consideration before we can actually finally get the lands available for the social housing or in terms of affordability of housing in terms of the weaker section of society. But hopefully at least some of the lands will be made available, so at least some possibility of development in this area, though I don't think much of the lands will be available in view of the fact that the CZMP plan has actually covered most of these in terms of the coastal zone. So we have a question mark as to whether the development plan of Mumbai or the CRZ plan, ultimately I believe the CZMP plan will superride the development plan if these coastal areas are not shown outside the CZMP. So big question mark on the affordable housing.
So Mr. Hiranandani, Mr. Fadnavis has said not once but several times 10 lakh new homes, affordable homes will be created. Of course, the definition of affordable, I have been told umpteen number of times whenever I've done any show on real estate, please have a different definition for affordable in Mumbai. Even if I take a price tag of up to 50 lakh, sir, where will we get these 10 lakh homes? It's this current government's promise. Can you see it in this DP at all?
The answer is yes and no. Yes, if tomorrow the pricing of the lands which they have got under the lands which they are going in terms of the salt pan lands or the other government lands which they have got on the periphery of the town, if that is cleared, then obviously they can price it at a price which will make it affordable. But if you are expecting that these will go on private lands where the additional FSI will be bought from the government on the ready reckoner rates, then there is no way to get it at an affordable price. So the challenge is really to see whether the development plan measure and the DC rules is actually a revenue earning measure or is it actually looking at the affordability of housing. I think these two are unfortunately in contradiction to each other at the time of finalization of the development plan and the DC rules. So some conflict there also needs to be cleared, whether they are looking at affordability or they are looking at revenue earning from projects and properties.
And that's always been the case, isn't it, sir? For every city, that's the case. I mean, across the country, if you map the land that PSUs hold or government holds, which can be released for affordable housing, is humongous. But the government also wants to extract its pound of flesh. They also want revenue. So it's always a catch-22 situation. But the worst, or I believe it's a dire situation for Mumbai. The housing shortage, especially in that under 50 lakh rupees, close to business districts, is just unbelievable. Having said that, I'll have to wrap out here. I mean, we could go on Mumbai Development Plan. It's a huge city, huge issues, huge solutions, all possible. Maybe we'll revisit this topic again after 24th October when we have the rules in place. Thank you, gentlemen. Mr. Devi Goenka, Rajiv Mishra, Vilas Nagalkar and Niranjan Hiranandani. Pleasure to have you with us. I'm going to sign off by just saying we can only hope that Mumbai Development Plan sees a much better implementation than the last one of 18%, as we've just been told, and doesn't just end up depending on that famous Mumbai spirit to keep itself chugging along. Goodbye from me.